Okay.
So Gamescom 2020 has officially kicked off, and with it came a lot of great announcements and game trailers. And while yes, there are a lot of games that they showed that I could be talking about, one really sparked my interest that I wanted to make this video on. It is the new title announced by Respawn Entertainment, and it is a virtual reality Medal of Honor game. For anyone who is unaware who Respawn Entertainment is, they're a huge game developer currently that are best known for Titanfall 1 and 2, Apex Legends, everybody knows about that game. And then, of course, Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order. And by the sounds of it, the new Medal of Honor VR game is called Above and Beyond, and it essentially sounds like it's going to be taking players in a first-person fashion into the front lines of World War II. This new VR title is coming to Oculus Rift and Oculus Quest, and it is set to release at some point, holiday season 2020. They have not given a definitive date on when it's going to be released, but we're really kind of heading into the fourth quarter of 2020, so it's only a handful of months away by the sounds of it. And I do have to say, big props to Respawn Entertainment. There's nothing I love more than when a game developer announces a game, but then doesn't make you wait for 5 years to play it. This game, by the sounds of it, hopefully it doesn't get pushed back, is still coming out within the next 4 months of the year. Medal of Honor Above and Beyond will take place through the historic events of World War II in an immersive VR experience. They did say the missions were going to be a mixed bag of first-person shooter style, but then they also said that they were introducing some first-person VR experiences in vehicles as well. So you're going to be taken on the ground and in the air in different vehicles. But yeah, honestly, just based on the gameplay that I'm showing you guys right now, I think that the gunplay looks great and smooth. I think that it looks like they're gonna actually let us kind of be more immersed in the world by being able to grab random objects. So in this clip, it's showing the player grabbing a statue of a guy and just smashing it over the head of a dude sitting there. So if you're gonna actually be able to make decisions like that, like, okay, I don't want to kill this guy, I'm just gonna grab this bust and smash him over the head with it, I think that really brings the immersion in a VR game. Versus some games in the past where basically your surroundings look really nice and cool, but you can't really interact with any of it. So I think this is looking pretty promising as far as that goes. It showed him grab some dynamite to blast open a door. It showed him throwing some knives at some guys, and all of it looked really smooth. So I'm hoping it's actually that smooth when the official game launches. And then it sounds like Respawn's really trying to get the locations and the actual historical battles that happened in World War II in this game. So there is going to be some actual places where actual battles happened in history. So they're really going for realism with this game. And they did say that they're really trying to base this on actual human experiences that happened during World War II. It sounds like they even did research on just interviews with people from World War II. So they're really going for basically bringing the virtual reality player into World War II to make an exciting experience, but not only that, a historically accurate one for the most part. The game's director, Peter Hirschman, even went as far as saying that the game's use of tragic events are to be grounded and emotionally authentic, to be as true as they can to the real experiences that happened to these people, especially the ones that actually fought and lived through this stuff. So not only are they bringing us an exciting historical game, and a historically accurate game at that, they're being respectful about it by the sounds of it, which is honestly more than you can say for a lot of World War II games, and there are a lot of World War II games out there. So yeah, that's about it. There's not a lot of information on the game yet. Basically that 2-minute trailer, and then you can actually head to the website of the game, and they actually have some blogs on there describing how they got their inspiration for the game, how they went about sound design, stuff like that. So if you're interested in that, go check it out. And overall, I'm just very excited for this game. For anyone who's watching this that isn't old enough to remember Medal of Honor, it is a game series that came out quite a while back, and that was basically my Call of Duty growing up. Don't get me wrong, I still had, you know, Call of Duty 1, 2, and 3 growing up, but Medal of Honor was honestly my cup of tea at the time. And I have a lot of fun memories with it, playing co-op. So I do think it's really great that they're actually bringing this series back to life, especially in a VR experience. So if they can pull this off, I think that it's gonna do a lot of justice for VR, because personally, I think we need more of these actual AAA title VR games that really bring like a cinematic and exciting experience to the player. And there are definitely a lot of titles that do that already for VR. Half-Life Alyx is basically the main one I can think of right now. That is a perfect example of someone who did a VR experience correctly or right. And I personally just think for VR to evolve to the next step, these are the type of games that we actually need. And I'm really hoping that they pull it off well, and I'm very excited to play it. For anyone who's just joining our channel for the first time, at the end of every Friday news story, we do a comment of the week section about our last Friday's news story. For anyone who did not catch it, it is talking about Fall Guys and whether it is going to come to the Nintendo Switch or not. Blake did a really great job on that video, so make sure to go check it out. I will link a card up top. So this week's comment of the week is coming from Ariana, and she said, "If not, they're wasting a big opportunity. The art style alone screams Switch." And I actually really have to agree. If someone was to just show me a video of Fall Guys and I knew nothing about it, and they asked me personally what console they think that it released on, I would say the Nintendo Switch in a heartbeat. It's actually surprising to me that it is only on PS4 and PC. And with the success that we have seen with the game so far, it is only a matter of time before it comes to Xbox and the Switch. So I guarantee it's gonna happen. Now, it's a matter of when it will happen. I don't really know, obviously, but if it's anything like the past Switch ports, it's gonna be quite a while before we get that on the Switch. And then also, of course, I would really love to see cross-platform play with that game. I think that it could really open up a world of fun between consoles. So basically, yes, I hope it comes to Switch. I think it will. Let's get some crossplay going. So thank you for the comment, Ariana. That pretty much is going to wrap up our Friday news story. I do want to know what you guys think on the new VR Medal of Honor game coming out. Drop some comments down below. Let me know what you think about it. Let me know if you have any questions. We'll get back to you as usual. Give the video a thumbs up. It really does help with the channel. And don't forget, if you guys want to see future news on tech, games, movies, literally anything nerdy in between, make sure to subscribe to Digital Cynics. Peace.